H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay. So we will see how we can actually connect to database from the application. Okay. So before we get started on how to saving the details, let me open MS Paint and show you how it actually happens. So from, imagine this is user. So when the user logs into a website or any application, so first request comes to the application server. So request comes to the application server, and from the application server, the values will be sent. Values will be validated or sent to the database. For example, here I am logging into a Gmail. So whenever I try to log into Gmail or Yahoo Mail or any website, for example, if I enter user ID and password, so the values like user ID and password will not be present in the application server. The values will be present in the database. So what happens here is, so from the application server, the values, username and password will be retrieved back, will be verified whether the matching user ID and password is present in the table or not. So in the database, we will have a table like this. So for example, we will have tables like this. So first one we have user ID, and next one we might have password. And if user ID and password both are matching, then we will send the respective mails to the UI. If user ID and password is not matching, we'll just tell them like, okay, your user ID and password, either user ID or password are invalid. Okay. So now we will try. So from the application server, we have to connect to database server. So this will be a separate system, separate server. This is called application server. Just a second. So this will be application server, and from in application server we will have all our files .aspx files .acx .asmx, all the files will be there in application server. And from the application server we will connect to database server. So this is another server, database server. So in my system I am having both application in my system and database also in my system. So both are in my system only. Normally for small applications where users, number of users connecting to the application are less, we can go for single server for both application and database. But in case if millions of users are accessing, if you have both in the same server, it might performance will be very less. So normally application server and the database server both will be different. So what we need to tell is, in our application we need to tell what are the details of the server, how we can actually connect. Okay, so let me show you some example, then you will understand. So let me open Visual Studio. So whatever we are discussing now, you have to practice today itself, otherwise so now I'll go to this here and I will be creating, let me close this. Okay, so let's take US batch and let's see what are the tables we have. I have a table called employee. So let me see what data we have in that table. So select star from employee. Okay, we have some data. So what we will be doing is, we will try to get the values of employees from the table and we'll display in the grid view. Okay, So here, let me create a new web application. File, new, project, and I'm going to create a web application. Visual Studio 2012 MT web application. And let me create this. So our goal for now is I want to display the table values from the database and display it in the web application. So till now we are doing a lot of applications, but we never written code to interact with database. So let's try to do how we can do it. Okay, so I'll add a web page here. Right click on this, add new item. I'm going to add a web form and give the name as home.aspx. Okay, I added a web form which is I named it as home.aspx. Yeah, so now what I'll do, I will go to this aspx.cs, and in the page load, of this, let me try to write the logic for connecting to database and then to display the table values. Okay, so in home.aspx page I will be adding a control called grid view. If you see here, we have standard controls, data controls, validation controls, navigation controls. Like this we have different types of controls. So if I click on data, I will have, so for displaying data we will have like form view, grid view, details view, data list. Like this we have different types of classes. So we normally will be using grid view to display values from the table. So let me drag this and put it here. So we have a grid view, and let me name this as GV grid view. GV indicates the grid view. GV employee details. Okay, now I will write the code in .cs file to populate this grid view. Okay, so now let's go to aspx.cs file. Okay, first thing, here the first thing which you need to tell is, you need to tell about your database server. So how do you connect to a database server? So because this file, aspx file, will be present in your application server, so you have to tell the details of database server. So what we need to do, we need to include three namespaces using system.data.sql using system.data.sql client. So these are the three namespaces which you need to include. So I will tell you how we need to connect now. So the first thing, I need to give the connection. So provide, I'm adding comments also, provide the details of connection. So here I'm writing SQL connection, CONN equal to new SQL connection. Okay, so SQL connection is a class which is present in, so you can see here, SQL connection is a class which is present in system.data.sql client. So that is the reason why I have included this system.data.sql client. So SQL connection is primarily used to connect to SQL server. So now I need to write, when you put brackets here, you can see there are one of two overloads. So one of two overloads. Now when I click on down arrow, you can see that this method, first method, is not accepting any parameter, and the second method is accepting string, connection string. So when I click on down arrow, so you can see here that this method, SQL connection, is a method present in is accepting, SQL connection is accepting a string which is connection string. So I'll provide here connection string. So let me provide a connection string here. Connection string will look like this. Okay, so I need to give, first I need to provide the details of data source. Data source is my server name. So I need to go here, I need to check what is my server. So this is our server detail. This is my server. So my server name is Meghnath PC. So if you don't know what is your server name, all you need to do is, you need to write here select @@server name. So you can write a command like this, select @ server name, click on execute. You can see the server name here. So I copy this server name and go to web.config, and here you can write like this, data source equal to this. After that, once you give the data source, you need to tell about. So in this server, normally we have so many databases. So you need to tell about which is your database. So our database now here is US batch. So you need to tell which database, in which database your table is present. So I need to tell here initial catalog. Initial catalog equal to US batch. And then I need to provide my username or password. So how I actually connected to database. Or I can give integrated security equal to true for Windows authentication. For Windows authentication, I can give integrated security equal to true. I'll tell you what is this. Okay, so I'm done with telling my, for the application, I'm done with telling like how can you connect to database. So data source equal to I give my server name, and initial catalog is in which database you have to fetch the value, and integrated security equal to true. And then now I'm done with my connection, and then I need to give command. I need to tell what command I need to execute. So SQL command cmd is equal to new SQL command. And here if you see, we have like overloaded methods. So we have four overloaded methods, and the first one is parameterless, and the second one is asking for string command text. So it is asking for what is your command text, and the third one is asking for string command text comma SQL connection. So here we will provide our string. So what is our command? I need to command text is something like select star from employee. So this is my command which I need to execute, and then comma, what is my connection? My SQL connection is CONN. Okay, so this is how you normally give a command. So ideally for this command object, you have to tell what is the command you want to execute, which is select star from employee, and what is the details of your connection string. So I want to execute this command in which server. So for that, you have to provide the details of what you created here. So for this command object, you have to tell two things. One is what is your command to be executed, and how you need to connect to the database. So now we gave both the details. Now what you need to do is, we need to write adapter. We need to write adapter. SQL data adapter DA is equal to new SQL data adapter. I'll tell this what is the use of data adapter. Now you see here what are the overloads here. So we have we have four methods here. The first one is parameterless. And the second one, we have SQL command select command. So here I think we can provide this command here. If we don't want to give command, you need to give like this. You can give a select string, so whatever we gave here, and then you can give connection. So now what we need to do, so we will take this method, the third method, select command. So I'm giving here cmd, that's all. So in case if you have not created this totally, this line totally, you could have selected the third overload. So which is like here, you can see that we have select command text, we have a string command text, and we have connection. So here you are giving this directly, these two values here for adapter. So I will tell you what is the use of adapter. So don't worry if you're not getting it now, I'll be explaining again. So cmd, okay. So once we got the adapter, so now let me go to MS Paint. So this is database, and to store the values, so normally if it's a small values like integer, float, double decimal, you can use int, float, double, like data type. But to store the values of a table, you need a special data type called dataset. So dataset is the dataset is the variable is the class of which object you can store the values of a table. See, from the database, if you are getting a table, see, when you write a command select star from employee, when you write a command select star from employee, that will return a table. So you cannot store this table in normal data types like integer, float, double decimal. These are all, this can store only small data types. If you want to store a table from the database, you have to create a special data type called data set. So what will happen here is you will write a data set object, and a data set will be filled by data adapter. So this data adapter is like something like a mediator between database and DB and dataset. So dataset, the value of dataset will be filled by data adapter. The name itself tells, like, adapter is something like which acts as a intermediate layer between DB and the dataset. So what we need to do now, we need to go back here, and then you need to create a dataset. Dataset is to hold the values of table. So what you need to do, dataset ds is equal to new dataset, and then now we have data adapter, which is which all the details of with the details of command and connection. Now we have dataset also to hold the value from the table. Now what we need to do, we need to fill data set using data adapter. Okay, so now what I'm going to do now, da dot fill, data adapter is filling ds. So now we have this data set filled by data adapter. So after this step, you will have your table inside this. So now what you need to do, we have the data set filled. Now assign the grid view, assign the data set values to grid view. So what we do here, gv employee details dot data source. What is the data source? DS. And then I will explain again, don't worry. Gv employee details dot data bind. Once we assign it, we need to bind it. So these are the steps we have for connecting to database. First thing you need to tell, what is your connection details? How do you connect to database? For that you need to tell your server name and database name. And what is the command? This command will tell you which table you want to get the details. So here you are telling server details and database details. And here you are telling the command which table you need to execute in this database. And data adapter, as I said, this will be used to connect between, this will be used to fill data set. So dataset is a special variable which will hold the values like table values, and then da.fill dataset. So this data adapter will fill the values into dataset, and finally what we are doing, we are giving this value to grid view. So let's run this and see how it looks like. So let me run this. See, now we are seeing the values in the UI. So this values we got it from the database. So I repeat again, so let me go back to this and let me put a breakpoint. All you need to do is you need to just click here. So let me stop this and run again and execute this again. So I'm executing now. So if you see here, first thing, we initialize the connection. We told that what is our connection string. So if you see here, this is our connection string. Data source is equal to Meghnad PC, initial catalog equal to US batch, and integrated security equal to true. So this is our connection. And then what we are doing, we told what is our command to be executed. So the command to be executed is select star from employee. Select star from employee. Now after that, what we need, SQL data adapter DA is equal to new. So we are initializing the data adapter. So remember, data adapter is used to fill the data set. It acts as a mediator between database and the grid view, and the database and the data set. So if you see here in our diagram, so data set is filled by data adapter. Okay, now press F10. Now after this line, this data adapter will fill the values into data set. See, now you can see here. So if you want to see the value, see this variable, you can just see like this. But if you want to see the values of data set, you need to click on this and you need to select data set visualizer. See, now this is the values which we are getting from the database. I repeat again, move your mouse to data set and then click on this small arrow and then select data set visualizer. You can see the values which are retrieved from the database. And then what you are doing here, you are assigning the data set to the grid view. You are telling that for this grid view, the data source is this data set. And then you are binding the values. That's all. So now we are displaying here. Okay. So how many of you understood this? How many of you understood? I got one message from Padmini. I understand, like she has some prior knowledge. How many else understood this? 50%, 60%, 70%. Yeah. Okay. So let me explain again. So first thing. Imagine if I ask you. Imagine you don't know anything, you don't have any SQL Server details, or you don't have any details. I'll come to you and just tell me, can you get the details from the database? So if I ask this question, can you get the details from the database, first thing what will you ask me? All of you, like I'll come to you and tell, like, can you get the details from database? First thing what you'll ask me, what is the server which I need to connect? What is the database which I need to look into? So you will ask those details to me. So first thing, I repeat again, if I come to you and ask you, like, can you get some details from database? So the values, the immediate questions you might ask you is, can you tell me while connecting to SQL Server, what do I need to enter here? That will be your first question. So when you click on this connect, you will ask me what is the server name and what is the database name which I need to look into, and then that's what here is our connection. So first I'm telling to my application what is the server I need to connect and what is the database I need to look into. So if I tell you get the values of employee table, you will ask me which database you want, because you have a lot of databases here. So that is the reason, first for connection you have to tell what is your server name and what is your database name. So that is the first point, that is what you are telling to connection. And then you will ask me what table you want to get the values. So for that we are giving command. So from the command we are trying to get the values. So those two are definitely useful to narrow it down to exactly what you need. Okay, so that is about connection and command. After that, as I told you, we have to use a data adapter to fill the data set. For this data adapter, you have to tell, see, if you have to tell to the data adapter which database you want to connect. So all these details till now, for database details, we have in connection and command. In connection, we have which server to connect, which database to connect, and in command, we have which table to pick. So these two values we are giving to adapter. So how we are giving to adapter? SQL data adapter DA is equal to new data adapter, and in brackets we give command. So this command is having both query and as well as connection details. So that we told to the adapter. And we created a variable data set for holding table values. After that, as I told,